Why'd you trust me? I could have split.
I had to trust you. Or else give up running in the ocean.
He hurt me. Nobody gets away with that.
All these years I've lived with this guilt for what I did. But you guys... Well, we all know that Knot's Landing is the world's most perfect community.
Richard.
I mean, a veritable utopia, the solar system's ideal community.
Richard!
But Laura left here to die.
Maybe you weren't the best mother in the world, but... I love you because... Because you're my mama.
Well, why don't you join me?
I never swim in shark-infested waters.
Laughing and carrying on with that guy like you're on a date. And that bothers you.
It makes me sick.
You are so simple.
You are such a slut.
Well, it takes one to know one, doesn't it, dear?
You with your little tract house, your little dead-end street, your little dead-end life, with your little outdoor barbecue grill and your kiss the cook apron. Oh, it all makes me sick.
He's a weakness. He is to me what alcohol is to him.
What do you think I am? The flavor of the month? And you marry Abby, you date Paul, and then you dump her when my mother bats her aging eyes at you. And the next time you want to give me a bonus? Write me a check.
Now cheer up. It's not as if you're going to be poor. Half of Gary's money is a fortune.
All of Gary's money is a fortune. Half of it is half a fortune.
Did she tell you about the wedding?
She knows.
The wedding? Yes.
How much does she know?
Paige? Yes.
No, Dracula's daughter. Pecca's new out of his will.
Well, isn't that good news?
She didn't know.
Well, I wanted to congratulate her in person.
And I'm the Queen of England.
How sweet.
I'm so flattered that you want to be like me. But don't flatter yourself into thinking we're at all alike. Everything I have, I've earned. Everything you have, you've been given. I know it galls you, it galls people of your class, to see a woman like me who's earned what you thought was yours by birth.
You know, I kind of felt sorry for him.
Well, leave it to Richard to think that if two women were having a relationship, one, of course, would have to pretend to be the man.
Poor Val isn't responsible for the way she feels, or the way she acts, or the way she is. You can't blame poor Val because she's poor Val.
Skirt, is it?
Yes. Skirt, actually.
Don't be a slave to fashion.
Olivia.
Honey, something terrible has happened.
What, you ran out of eye makeup?
Oh, I mean, Mac is everybody's dream husband. My record in the husband-picking department is not all that good.
But this is Gary we're talking about here, as in, I hope Gary and Val get back together again.
People still say that?
Only at the mention of your name or his.
You know, I'm glad we had this chance to chat. It's important for me to know where my business associates stand.
And where's that, Cookie?
In the 19th century. You may think that women belong at home, barefoot and pregnant, but you've never dealt with me before.
Let the second Mrs. Ewing give the soon-to-be third Mrs. Ewing a friendly warning. The first Mrs. Ewing doesn't go away. Ever.
Do me the honor being my wife.
Probably.
I was hoping for a yes. I think I was, you know, I could handle a no, but I don't know how to handle a problem.
Hello. It's like old times, isn't it?
Vultures circling.
Are you drunk?
We haven't seen each other in years.
But when my liver gets profiled in the business section, bingo, you're here to help with the funeral arrangement.
What are you talking about?
You heard the news. And your wicked heart rejoiced at the prospect of your baby brother's demise.
A successful career in real estate would be building the World Trade Center in New York and renting out all that space at a handsome profit. You sold little houses.
Well, this person who built your wonderful towers, was he an abandoned mother of two small boys?
Rubbish.
Well, I'm not saying we're having an affair. And I'm not saying we're not. I am saying I can have him anytime I want him.
I came from a place that it would be hard for you to imagine. The things you presumed on growing up, I never had. Sometimes I never heard of them. Look at me.
So actually, I really don't want to say goodbye. She said I love you very, very much. And I'll see you later. Maybe.
She wants to know why we're living together. Don't you have a close relationship with Katie?
She's not going to tell me.
Oh, we're close. But I wouldn't risk our friendship by living with her.
Your daughter wouldn't live with you for $1 million.
I bet Greg was glad to see you.
How well does she know Greg?
Well, he's not the effusive type.
He told you to get lost.
You're in me. Not in there.
Taking it off my finger will mean I'm starting to let go. Not of our love or our marriage. Or our beautiful, sacred memories.
Our lovemaking has nothing to do with that. Because if I ever have to make a choice between love and money, money's gonna win every time. Simple enough?
Couldn't be simpler.
You don't have to live the rest of your life denying it the way I have. All you have to do is tell me that you don't want to go in there. Tell me to take you someplace else, kid. Just tell me to take you someplace else.
I don't care anymore. I don't care that I was a bad mother or that Jonathan beat you. I only care that you have become a monster. And you trample on everybody. You devour everything you touch.
Can I kiss the bride?
Gary, I'm afraid that would cause a terrible scandal.
I hope you're happier with Ben than you've ever been in your life.
You are probably one of the cruelest women I have ever met in my life. You would do anything, say anything to come between Gregory and me, just to fulfill your obsession. Well, don't bother, Mrs. Galveston, because if being with him means I have to spend any time with you, I am not interested. I'm gonna go home and take a bath.
Take a bath, I'll join you.
No, darling, why don't you stay here and have dinner with Mommy? Because if she's left here by herself with nobody to pick on, she just might start gnawing on her own arm.
I don't want us to be civil to each other, and I don't want you to pretend like you like me all of a sudden. If you want to show your gratitude, save a whale in life.
I knew she was trouble the first time she walked through that door. So what'd you do, Mac? You fall for her all the way. Should have taken French in school, cul-de-sac, dead end. I should have known. Everyone in there's a basket case.
If you were stranded in a desert with no food or water for 3 days and you came upon Abby Cunningham with a picnic basket, keep going.
That's bad.
If you force me to go back with you, I will tell any court in the world that you knew that Gary was the father of Val's twins, and you knew that they were alive and kidnapped, and you didn't do anything about it.
I don't want
to look at the world through rose-colored glasses. I want the world to be rose-colored. I want people to be nice. People should be nice. Nice should be the norm. I hate it that I can't trust anyone. I hate it that I can't put my daughter on the front lawn by herself. I hate it that I have to lock my car and I have to worry about an alarm system in my house and I can't send cash in the mail. That's not the way it's supposed to be, Gary. I liked being a Pollyanna. I want to be a Pollyanna.
Well, Dad, congratulations. You have hatched a new breed of barbarian. A creature determined to surpass even you in creating his own world.
You're good. You really are. If I were rating you on the Abby scale, Abby being a 10, you'd be a 6. Which is very good, considering your youth and ignorance.
Well, I don't judge things on the Abby scale.